For one local family, the new year means reliving the death of their son, who they say died unjustly at the hands of New Orleans police. WDSU News anchor LaTanya Norton is on your side with their story and their quest for closure.
January 1st, 2009, at 3:03 a.m.
It's a day forever etched into his mind. For Adolph Grimes Jr. and his wife, Patricia, New Year's Day is nothing to celebrate.
Nothing but another day. Because it's not a celebration.
Every day, it's a nightmare. When they get around the holidays, it's even worse.
The new year marked the second anniversary of the tragic death of their son, Adolph Grimes III. Back in 2009, the 22-year-old was shot and killed by New Orleans police officers in the 1700 block of Governor Nichols Street. He was sitting in a car outside his grandmother's home when approached by plainclothes officers looking for a shooting suspect. Grimes ran.
And when he got to the corner, there were six more waiting. So these were nine officers emptying their weapon and a 125-pound child. I guess when his blood ran out, flipped him over, handcuffed him, and shot him in the back of his head.
An autopsy shows Grimes was shot 14 times, nine times in the back.
I could just hear the bullets.
After the shooting, former NOPD Superintendent Warren Riley said Grimes shot at police first, a claim his family disputes.
They never found the shell cases for it.
Although Grimes did have a gun and a permit, an internal investigation by the NOPD cleared all officers of any alleged wrongdoing. However, the federal investigation remains ongoing. Also ongoing are the family's efforts to keep their loved one's memory alive, for themselves and for the little boy who'll never know his father.
That's a pain. That's something that'll never go away.
I want to hurt somebody at times, but, you know, that's not the right thing to do. But I want justice. I want justice.
On your side, LaTanya Norton, WDSU News.
NOPD Superintendent Ronald Surpass released this statement, quote, "The NOPD continues to cooperate with the ongoing federal investigation regarding the death of Mr. Grimes," end quote.